Yebo yebo, Mr. Karinge.
Yes, sir.
Welcome to the African Connection Show.
Thank you.
Of course, you know, but this one is a free spirit show. You know, you have to talk about yourself freely without fear or intimidation.
Yeah.
You understand me?
Thank
you. So I see, like, you've drawn a very good picture. A very nice portrait of Angela Fisher, the famous photographer, and Carol Beckwith.
It's a huge inspiration when I look at this. They have like 30 years worth of photography, which is absolutely crazy. And they have all this history and all this information documented in these books.
Yeah, man, yeah. So in other words, you know, as we know, Allan Donovan was an expatriate, he's a foreigner that came here, and he saw the importance of culture, preserving culture and the artifacts that he normally collects.
It's a big wake-up call for a lot of people who call themselves, you know, Africans or leaders or stuff like that. Like, you really are paving the way for a lot of things. To look at these people.
Now, we know the importance of culture, and we know the importance of telling our own stories and not to wait for the Westerners to come and tell us. I got nothing against that. I really appreciate that. You know, for people like Allan Donovan to come here and see the importance of even preserving our own culture. It's not their own, but if you look at, he saw the importance of even building a house that really represents the African heritage and all that. Yeah, you know. So, in other words, what you're saying, the Ministry of Culture should do something more than what they have right now, more than having an office.
Yeah, I think openly, what we are saying, it's like the Ministry of Culture in this country is, to say the least, a failed institution.
Yes, I know what you're saying. The first thing, in order for these things to work, even us as Africans, we need to embrace ourselves and our culture.
Yeah.
Embracing ourselves is embracing everything that is Kenyan or African.
Absolutely.
You understand?
Yeah.
When things like proposals, if it come as it come, it's for the ministry to work with people who are actually, people who are professionals in that field, or people who really understand that field, than
are.
Just having other people. And one of your culture is wearing sisal and playing, and wearing a kitenge. He doesn't know, you know that shit.
When it comes down to the ministry, because why we are talking about this, but this is the leadership, because it's more important when this comes from the leadership.
You know,
taking a first hand in this. The people themselves have a role to play, as you know, as a African people, as a Kenyan people, to preserve. But when you look at the bigger picture, when we have the leadership, you know, taking the front line and making things work, it makes it much easier, because let's face it, the leadership has the resources. Individual people don't have the resources.
What would you advise upcoming artists to do in terms of culture and in terms of where they come from, instead of drawing a Picasso? Picasso is a Western story. What would you tell, what would you advise them to do about African history, about our own stories? You understand me? Rather than, it's not bad appreciating other people, Picasso and them, but that's their story. What about us? You know, what about us?
As an artist, a community, the kind of opportunity that there is for us is because there's a lot of work to expose around African concepts. That people need to have that Afrocentric mindset and develop concepts around Africa, because there's so much that is not out there. Because everything else is saturated all the Picasso stuff is saturated. Yeah. Every artist in the world is doing that stuff. Mm-hmm. And maybe, just maybe, that's why the market is saturated, the artists are not getting opportunity, even sell work. What do you think? What about you coming up with something new straight out of Africa? Yeah. That will be new content, this will be new opportunities. And I think people will now find a new edge in, you know, exploiting the African environment, the concepts, the creativity around Africa to develop something really new, you know, in the entire artistic process. I think that's a new direction that, especially Africa, because African artists, we are the ones in this setup that we need to pioneer this kind of, you know, this kind of work out there in the coming century.
Yeah.
It's going to be something new.
That's very good. Yeah, man. Bless up, Mr. Karinge. The best artist on earth.
Bless up.
No, I don't want you to get a big head, but you're doing an amazing job.
Thank you.
And I'd like you to mobilize the way you did with Clever Arts, you know, but now you have Vipaji, and bring these people together. We'll start with 1, 2, 3, mobilize the soldiers, and let us tell our own stories, man. Bless up. This is your host, Juice Toe, Mr. Juice. You know, Culture Hub, the African Connection. We out.